For InsideMLAI ML. Every day we are bombarded with information. Just take this news site for example. Now we are going to a news site which is owned by Amazon founder. Yes, he bought this newspaper. So, like this, there are so many newspapers and websites which are filled with information. What if we could write a program that would summarize an article and give us its gist? So, let's pick a random article today. We will copy its URL and store it into a variable called as article URL. We'll pass it as a string and I am pressing shift enter to execute the cell. Now we will import URL lib so the standard library has been moved to URL lib 3. Now it has imported properly. Now we will import beautiful soup. Beautiful soup is a Python library that lets us process HTML, and we will say call it into our namespace with the alias as soup. If you have not previously installed BS4, then you can run the command exclamation mark pip install BS4 to install the library. It will take some time, after which we will execute this cell. Next, we will see what methods we have available on the URL lib 3. Module. We will pass in the variable storing our URL into URL open. That variable was article URL. Now we can see beautiful soup has been imported as soup. Now we want to read the contents of the page and decode it. So I already checked, but you can check in the source of the page that the page is encoded in UTF-8. So we will write here UTF-8 and we will pass in an additional parameter ignore for those characters which cannot be understood by our URL lib 3 library. Now we we will see what are all the attributes available to us in the model URL lib 3 by pressing tab. We can see that URL open is not one of them. However, we have your HTTP response, HTTP connection pool, we will go with HTTP response. So the right syntax is URL lib 3. Request URL open, and we will pass in our article URL. We want to read the contents of the URL and decode them. As we did previously, ignore any special characters. We will comment this out. Single line comment instead of a doc string, and here we will run this. After importing URL lib, while that loads, we will see what else we can do. We can start working with the beautiful soup library. So here is the contents of the website in HTML format. It is very ugly and difficult to read. So we will create a soup object and we will call soup. We want to call soup on this content. So we will first save it as page, our page. We will pass that page to our soup object and we will specify the format. LXML. It is throwing an error, so we will skip that for now. Let's see our soup object. Looks the same, right? So, but it gives us additional functionality, which is to find tags easily. So this is everything, including the tag itself and everything that is inside the article tag. So if we go back, we can see if it is in the article tag. We we can see there is a bunch of JavaScript. And you search for the article tab. We are finding a bunch of meta tags. Hey, what was that? Now this is some CSS. Lot of CSS. Some links. And that's it. We are back. We can read, however, that article is somewhere in there. So we'll continue with our processing by telling the soup object to find the article tag and give us its text. Okay, now this is much more readable, only the text of the article. We will continue on our journey by storing our findings as in the variable text. We want to find all the occurrences of the HTML tag article. Let's run this. Let's check what our text has. So we have saved all this, the text, into a variable text. Now, as a intermediate step, we want to encode it as ASCII characters. And if we are getting any errors while doing that, we will simply like to replace them. And here we can see that should do it. Yes, see, this Unicode convention has been replaced with a question mark, and to remove the question mark we will replace it again, this time removing the question marks with a blank space. Let's see what have we. We'll check the text again. We will encode it into as ASCII characters. If there are any errors, we would like to replace it anyway. Then we would like to replace all the resultant question marks in place of ASCII characters like these. And we want to replace them with an empty string. So it is giving us an error over here. We would try specifying again, errors, replace, we we will store it in the variable ASCII text, and on ASCII text we want to replace it. Takes no keyword arguments. Now we will put everything we have written into a handy function so we can apply it and have higher usability. We will name our function getText, and in that we will have a parameter passable called URL, which will be the URL of the page we want to summarize. Then we will have a page variable in which we will have URL lib.request.cv. Basically what we have written here, and then in this we will pass again the URL we are getting from the function call. We would like to read the contents of the URL. We would like to decode it as UTF-8. Next, we would like to call the soup object, create a soup object by calling beautiful soup, which has been imported as soup, and pass the page to it as an HTML page. Next, we would like to save the extracted text into a variable called text after getting in all the valid words which are not HTML tags. To get all the words, we will use the findAll method provided to us by beautiful soup, and we will pass in the article HTML tag to it. Next, we would like to our function to return us the text variable, and that would be it. So we are using a lambda anonymous function over here. This is a keyword, that's why it is, you can see it in dark green, keyword provided to us by Python. Let's see how whether our function is working by passing it get our function getText, and we'll pass it the article URL we had saved earlier. Let's see what happens. While that works, we will now so it is saying soup was referenced before assignment, so we will remove the HTML tag and let soup figure for us the content, the type of content on the page, whether it's HTML, CSS, something else. Now to do the actual summarization, local variable soup assigned before assignment. Okay, so let's just give it another name, and then here we will call that soup object, not beautiful soup herself. we will start some imports by the time that happens, NLDK. Let's see, we have an attribute error. Result set object has no attribute find all. You are probably treating a list of elements like a single element. Did you call find underscore all function when you meant to call find? We meant to call find all, that's true. For articles, let's see how many. If we have only one article, then what happens? Till then we'll do our imports from NLDK.tokenize import send tokenize. Let's see, again we have the same error. Result object has no attributes as you are probably treating a list of elements like a single element. Did you call find all when you meant to call find? That's interesting. We will also need, let's see, word tokenize. Here we did not get any error. Join. Text soup dot find all article map join. Let's see, soup page. If at this line, so we will run our function and we will pass in our article URL to it. Let's see if we get the article. By then we will make some imports for our summary function, main function which does the summary. Okay, this looks acceptable. Now for the main summarization function, we will need send tokenize and word tokenize from the NLTK, from NLTK libraries tokenize module. We will also need from the same NLTK library the corpus modules stop words list. Also, we will import punctuations from string and lastly, okay, we will stop after one last import which would be n largest, the n largest numbers from the heap queue library. We'll import n largest. We'll do these imports. So if we get an error saying module not found, then in that case you will have to pip install nltk. This may take some time. So what we want to do is use the send tokenizer to tokenize our text. So we want to use the send tokenizer to tokenize our text. Let's see, it is working. After pushing them down to the lower case, also we would like to create a set of stop words. It says we cannot import punctuations. Why is that? Okay, we misspelled. It is punctuation, not punctuations. Punctuation. We already have NLTK. It says already satisfied. We have imported it. Have you imported it? We have imported it. After you have installed NLTK, you will have to run nltk.download. Oh, first we'll have to import NLTK. Import NLTK, nltk.download. We will need send tokenizer for tokenizer, stop words, and that's it. Next, what we would like to do is tokenize all words in text after turning them to lowercase. Also, we would like to create a set. Set means a set has unique elements. By combining the stop words, the English stop words from the stop word list in NLTK, as well as the list of punctuations from string which we have just imported, let's see if you can see this. So from what we need today is I think we have what we need. Let's check one more time. Let's refresh. I think that would do for now. Let's close this. And let's just comment this out. we'll store this in sense. Let's print out sentences, sense. And this combined list, we would like to store in the variable stops. Let's take a look at our stop words, collection of stop words. Now, we would like to see every word which is in our okay, this is taking some time to load. I will pause this for now. Let's rerun to see. Let's rerun. Let's comment it out so it does not install it again. It's saying it is installed. Again, we'll do the imports. The imports have been done. Now we want to take a look at our sentence tokenizer. Looks good. Next, we would like to take a look at our word tokenizer. Okay, these are all our words. We would like to save our words in the variable words. Okay, now let's take a look at punctuation. It's saying we have not defined punctuation. A typo over there. Let's take a look at all our punctuations and stop words combined. Now we want a word for every word in words. So just so you remember, these are all our words. So we want every word for every word and stop words in words if that word is not in our list of stop words. Let's take a look. Sounds good, looks good. Let's save this into words. We will likely have to do another import at this point from the probability module of the analytical library. We will now import the frequency distribution function. Now we have the dist function in our namespace. We will pass our list of words to the frequency distribution function and store the result in freq variable frequency. Let's take a look at it. So this character appears 28 times, COVID-19 appears 20 times, and so on. It is giving us the frequency distribution of each word in our words list. Now we want to see the 10 largest and largest words means most occurring. We want to see their frequency distribution. We'll pass in the key get method on the frequency variable. Let's see. These are the 10 most occurring words. Official deaths, India, city death. So we can guess the topic that it is about the official governmental response to the COVID deaths in India. Now we will take a moment out to import the default dict from the collections library. This is a standard library, so we don't need to pip install it first. It is a standard library which comes pre-installed with Python. When you download Python from its website, python.org. Oops, a letter misspelled over there. Now what we want to do with default dict is call default dict on the int built-in data type and store the values in the rankings variable. No errors there. Now we would like to run a for loop which iterates over the iterables I and sent. These will be our iterables in our list of sentences which we have stored in the sent variable, and we will have a nested for loop. We will iterate over a variable in the after running the function. For every time we run the function word token nice for that send, see this send is this send for short for sentence. For each sentence which has been lowercased, after this we want to check if our iterable is in frequency. That frequency variable we have over here, that frequency, and if it is, which it most likely will be because we made the frequency variable from the words, we will like to assign it an a ranking I, and every time we find that word we will count up, add 1 to its value. So it is saying that ranking is not defined. We defined rankings over here. Now it should work fine. Let's take a look at ranking. So this is the default dict. This is a built-in data type of Python. And here we can see about less than 50 words and the number of times they occur in our article. Now we would like to set an ID value for each sentence and we'll also pass in the ranking. Unlike previous time, we will call the get method on ranking like this. Let us take a look at our sentence IDs. Everything looks good. Now for every jth sentence, for J in our list of sentence IDs, we would like to sort them before, or you can say rather while iterating over them, variable. So here we are overwriting it. So we will use another variable called as word sent, and over here we will use the frequency distribution function on that variable, and we don't seem to use it again. Let's run this. Okay, first we will have to run this. Run all. Let's do that. While it comes to our current cell, let's write a function that summarizes everything given the text. And number of lines you want the text summarized in. Let's recap what we learned. See if you can guess which variables we will be using. We will use the send tokenize function on the input text, after which we will assign to words the output of word tokenize on the text, plus the method to turn it into lowercase. In here, between here, we could write an assert statement just to make sure the number of lines you want the text summarized in is actually lower than the actual number of sentences in the text. After which we will create our own assorted list of stop words, which is actually a set, because we are combining two sets of stop words and we want to count each element in the set only once. So we will use the list of English stop words from NLTK, as well as the list of punctuations from string, punctuation from string, after which we will use list comprehension to get every word for word in words. If that word is not in our list of stop words, we'll save this into word sentences just to have a different variable name over there. Then we will call frequency distribution function from probability module of NLTK into we'll call that function on our word sends, after which in a variable called ranking we will initialize the default dict to integer values, after which we will write a for loop to iterate over a dummy variable I and word sends in enumerate word sends. Let's use singular over here because that was the iterable. For the second time, we will iterate over the tokenized words for word sent which would have been lowercase for us. And for the last time, we will only iterate if that word is in frequency or list, in which case we will up its count by increasing its frequency. Let's get out of this if, for and for loops. Then we will store the sentence IDs, are just we'll pass in n number of sentences we wanted article summarized into, the ranking of the word, as well as setting the key to ranking.get, and we will return the sentences which we have saved as word sense. The jth element of word sense for j are iterable in sorted list of sentence IDs. This should do the trick. Now we will call our summarize function on our text and summarize the text in three sentences. Let's debug our code to see what went wrong. Let's call our stop words list and append to it these punctuation marks. Let's see, set object has no attribute append. So we cannot append to a set, but we could add to it one at a time, like this. And add for a second time. And add for a third time. Like this. And now let's try to run our code once more. Let's take a look at the stop words. Let's see if we can find any more stop words. Let's take this one in. Add and here we go. running a functions one more time. We are pressing control, actually shift enter. So this is our function. Let's run it. Let's ask for three sentences that summarize our text. So these are the three sentences that encapsulate the gist of our text. Let me read them. He said the crematorium has been receiving 100 bodies a day, unheard of before this year, and most of them are COVID-19 patients that are wrapped in. This is the first sentence. The second sentence is, in Rajkot, COVID-19 deaths are counted only after they are vetted by a death audit committee at the main hospital. City officials confirmed. Story continued. This was the second sentence. And the third sentence is, my mother could have been saved if there was oxygen. Maitreyi Muzumdar in Ahmedabad and Saurav Sharma in Lucknow contributed to this story. Read more.